The new Jaclyn Hill video just dropped and I got a lot to say about it and you might not like it. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel, I'm not a drama channel. My channel is actually about mental health. So sometimes what I do, I take what's going on in the YouTube community or pop culture and see what lessons we can learn from it to improve our mental health. So if you came here to get some tea, it ain't happening. But I'm just kidding, this isn't tea, this is actually coffee. Look at this mug, look at that mug. I actually got that at a Corgi Beach Day this year in California. I love it. Look, it says butt first coffee and it has a little corgi butt. Fun fact about me, I actually don't like tea. I don't like tea one bit. It tastes to me like lightly flavored water. I'm just not into it, but don't thumbs down the video just because I don't like tea. I know there's a lot of tea fanatics out there, right? But anyways, so before I get started talking about Jaclyn Hill, I do wanna say full disclosure, I don't know much about Jaclyn Hill. Like, I'm just getting into this stuff because of my girlfriend and her best friend. So fun fact, another fun fact, two fun facts in one video. My girlfriend and her best friend Shelby and I, we're all in a little group chat where we just like sit there and talk about all the stuff going on in the beauty community. Like, that's really weird. That's really weird. Like, if I told that to people, that'd be, yeah, they'd think about me differently, but I don't really care. And you know what? That's actually gonna be a topic in this video. But anyways, yeah, so we talk about it and stuff, but my girlfriend's friend Shelby was telling me about some of the stuff and the controversies going on with Jaclyn Hill. I'm like, oh, wow, that's crazy. So just so you know, like, I'm gonna be talking about this video specifically, what lessons we can learn from it, and that's about it. Like, I'm not gonna dive into past stuff with her. I know just a little bit, and I don't wanna voice my opinion about it, but there's a couple things. So like, when it comes to our mental health, and this is one of the reasons I'm really big on meditation. So meditation, or mindfulness meditation, which is what I practice, it's about cultivating curiosity, okay? So much of what we're doing throughout the day in our head, we're judging, right? We're judging other people, situations. A lot of times we're judging ourselves. And this kind of helps give me clarity and kind of clear some stuff up. So I want you guys to get kind of curious and like, I just want you to question some things because so many of us are just like on autopilot and it's really interesting to me. And like, not necessarily like right or wrong when it comes to certain topics, but like, I want you to just kind of ask, like, why do I care so much? Why do things bug me so much? Why do I think this way and not that way? And all sorts of stuff. One of the topics I wanna talk about is like, Jaclyn addressed like the drama community, okay? And some of the things and like what happened with like Marlana Estelle's video or Makeup Geek, you know, she like showed part of her, you know, email and things like that. And she was talking about, you know, all these rumors floating around and she wanted to address them and stuff. And this is something that's really interesting to me. And as my channel grows, my loyal subscribers out there, I want you to kind of keep me in check and maybe bring me back to this video, because something that I talk about, I was actually just talking to a young woman on Instagram, and we care so much about what other people think. I'm gonna link in the info card up here about how to quit caring so much about what people think about you, okay? This is crucial, but at a certain point, when you get to this big place, like, I just personally don't see why you need to let people know so much information, right? Like, I don't know, I deal with, you know, I work at a drug and alcohol treatment center, let's talk about that. And a lot of people, they'll ask me, they're like, what do I say when I get back home and I go back to work and people start asking me? I'm like, you tell them it's none of their business. And then they're like, whoa. Like, it's weird how that doesn't even cross our mind. Like, this just isn't any of your business. Like, if you watch the Jaclyn Hill video, it probably gave you more questions than it did answers. There were so many things because there's confidentiality and business and da-da-da-da-da. Like, that's one of the reasons why we gotta prove to people with our actions rather than our words, you know? Now, as you get bigger, like, one reason that I would say, like, Jaclyn did need to make this video, like, the first half of it, really, was because she's a business owner, right? And there's some, I guess there's some stuff going on with her palette. Is it a palette? I think it's a palette. Or was it brushes? I don't know what it is. But anyways, like, as a business owner, yeah, it's good to communicate and be transparent about that stuff and say, hey, we're trying to fix this. Like, that's cool. But as far as like personal life and friendships and things like that, like, although it makes for good, I don't know, entertainment, you know, in the drama community and all that kind of stuff, like, I just, like, ask yourself, like, why do you feel other people need to know this about you? Why do they need to know certain things? Why do they need to know your intentions? I literally just made a video about how to earn forgiveness and how your actions speak louder than your words. I constantly said how your actions speak louder than your words. I just wanna drill that into your head. Your actions speak louder than your words. So Jaclyn has some like previous controversies and she's saying she's trying to learn and grow from it and stuff like that. What actions has she taken, right? What actions? Because as you continue to do things, people will learn who you are. Like remember, to thine own self, be true. Like, I had to get it through my head a long time ago, I am never going to please 100% of people. People are gonna have their opinions, they're gonna have their judgments. Some people just literally do not like fat guys with beards. I can't do anything about that. That's cool, you know what I mean? But to try to fight and try to earn this respect and things like that, like, quit doing that because your words are just words. No matter what statements you put out in regards to your personal life or your friendships or your moral code, like, you're gonna get some diehard fans who believe you, you're gonna get other people who are extremely skeptical about it. It's just what's gonna happen. So I want you to think about this in your own personal life, like, what are you trying to prove? How much effort, how much are you putting into this thing to show people who you are? There's this thing that I'm gonna do more videos on, like self-seeking, right? Like, and an example is the friends that you have, or you might be that friend who goes on Facebook and always tells everybody like, oh, look, look, I'm feeding a homeless guy. I gave somebody some money. I did this nice thing for somebody, because they're trying to give you an image of themselves. And a lot of people in this day and age, like, we don't buy it, you know? We wanna see it, we just wanna know that, you know, you're being a good person just for being a good person, not trying to get credit or recognition. And this leads into my second point. And this is something where, when I talk about the clarity that I want you to get, and I could do another whole video on this, but what's really fascinating to me is how people try to equate not making money with high moral code. Here's what I mean by that. So Jaclyn spent some time in her video about how she's turned down $1 million offers, how she turned them down. And one of her reasons is like, she just felt it in her gut. Like, she'd look back on it and wouldn't want to do it, even though she loves the brand, she loves the product. So I'm sitting there like, what? You know what I mean? Like, but it's rampant. Like, I'm sure a lot of people are like, oh my God, she turned down $1 million. What a good person. Why does that equate to being a good person? Like, my son's sitting over here in the living room, just right behind this camera. And like, imagine if I just like ran around like saying like, I'm a really good person. Like, we're homeless, but I'm a good person. I just refuse to take money. I refuse to, you know, buy things. I refuse, you know, I just don't want money because I want you to know that I'm a good person. Like, the other part of like YouTube culture is, like, I noticed this on my video about dissociative identity disorder. Like, people literally commented and said, like, think about this for a second. Like, isn't this interesting? People literally said, I think this person's telling the truth because they don't put ads on their videos. Like, think about that. Like, that's how you decide whether or not you believe somebody, is if they put ads on their videos? Like, why? Why is that? We all, you know, most of us, we live in America, or a lot of us live in different societies that unfortunately are run by capitalism, where we need to exchange money for goods and services and things like that. So I just want you to sit back and ask yourself, like, why do you think that someone's a better person if they don't make money? Like, when we're talking about our mental health, like, I don't know, my life got a lot better when I started questioning some of the things that I believed, right? Like, that's what meditation and mindfulness does for me. I sit down and I get quiet, and when I'm noticing my thoughts in my experience, I'm sitting there, I'm just like, why do I believe that? Where did this belief come from? Was it my parents? Was it somebody I, you know, idolized? Was it, you know, this person who said this? Like, where did this thought or idea come from? Is that thought even me? Are these opinions even mine, or are they something I inherited from somebody else, you know? And I would love to hear your thoughts. Like, leave them down in the comments below. Like, I would love if you just left me an explanation why you think less money equals higher morals, you know? Because I can think of a bunch of people off the top of my head who make a ton of money and their moral code is amazing. Like, For example, Jacksepticeye. That dude does charity live streams every month. He just donated a ton of money to St. Jude's Hospital. You know, without his following, without his money, without his resources, he wouldn't be able to do that very good thing, you know? So I'm not saying like whether or not Jaclyn Hill's a good person, and then that might bug you a little bit, but like, I just wanna take a perspective of what actually happened, what was said, and just kind of have you like question these things. Even with yourself, like why do you need to give some people so much more information? Why is making less money a good thing? Now, don't get me wrong, when it comes to our careers, like I'm about to tell you something and it's not even about what I was just saying. But here's an example of when you should take less money. I'm gonna make a video pretty soon about a job I had. And let me know if you want me to make this video. You can leave that in the comments too. I used to work for a company that was soul crushing, okay? It had to do with MLMs, which is multi-level marketing, which is the fancy term for pyramid schemes, and I made a lot of money. And since improving my mental health, I can't go back into that industry or sales industries. There's a lot of people who can do that with a good moral code and things like that. For me, I didn't trust myself. Like, those of you who know me, I say I used to be an awful person. But anyways, the job I have now, I make half as much money as I used to make. But it's not to say, oh, look at me, I'm a good guy, I'm not making that much money. For me, I share that to my clients especially because I want them to know that money won't make you happy. Because a lot of us do sacrifice our morals for money, right? So like when it came to Jaclyn Hill, when she said that she loved and respected these brands that she turned down like $1 million offers from, I'm like, that's just ridiculous. It doesn't make sense. I was actually talking to my girlfriend the other day because all this stuff about like people charging $60,000 and things like that. I was talking to her and we were discussing it and I was like, listen, if I ever got really big as a YouTuber, really big, right? And some company that I truly believed in asked me to do a sponsored video for $60,000, would you tell me not to take it? She's like, heck no, right? So like, it depends on where that money's coming from. Does it conflict with your moral code, you know, and things like that. But like, if it's something that you back and you love and you do like think that other people should get it, then do you, baby. Make your money. Make that dollar bills, yo. You know what I'm saying? But anyways, I just want to share my thoughts and have you think a little bit about this stuff. I can't wait to see what you guys say down below. Let me know your comments. Let me know your thoughts, all right? But that's all I got for you. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, even though I don't like to drink tea. And if you're new here, my channel's all about mental health. Make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And I want to take a second to give a huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. I love you so much, all right? That's all I got for you. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.